Good afternoon, my dear friend. After last video, we are going to switch for preparation of estimate. In this, we are going to see the detail estimate. So, first of all, we will see the data required for detail estimate. Generally, while going for the estimating, one should have the data required for the estimate, which is nothing but the plans, sections, and the other relevant details of the work. From plan and section, we can have the length, width and height of the item of work, and from section we can understand the type of work which is being there. Already we have seen the section wise we can get a sequence of execution by this particular section in last video. After you are having plans and section, we will having specifications in which the quality of work is dependent, and accordingly the rates of that particular item of work is being dependent. So the second one thing is that specification indicating the exact nature and class of the materials to be used. Then obviously the last one is the rates at which the different item of work are carried out to enable an estimator to take out the quantities accurately. The estimator should know how to take the measurements from the drawings to the true to the fact and to the scale, and hence he is supposed to get the proper drawings to the scale drawn. Accordingly, he can get the measurements if any absolute is there. So this was the data required for an estimator. Then how we are going to go for an estimation? For that, it is the steps in preparation of detail estimate. So obviously, for going for an estimation, one has to take out the quantities from the drawings. So in this method, what we are going to do is that we are supposed to get the different unit of measurements, and we have to record it into the measurement sheet. Then the second step is squaring out. Obviously, after getting out the quantities, we are going to calculate the quantities by multiplying the length, width, height and numbers, and last one is nothing but the abstracting. After calculating, taking out the measurements and squaring out whatever quantities we are getting for different item of work, we will record it into the abstract sheet, and by taking the rates for particular item of work from DSR, that is district schedule rate, or the rate analysis, we will get an abstracting. This step will be the abstracting. We will calculate the cost of each and every item of work. We will add the some different percentage of the rates. Then the final cost can be found out. So this was the steps involved for preparation in detail estimate. Now we will look for the methods for taking out the quantities. Generally, what we have seen just now, that there are three particular steps involved into the taking out quantities, squaring out and abstracting. But for this taking out quantities, again there are two different kind of methodologies to calculate the quantities for load bearing structure particularly, because hereafter we are going for the calculation of the quantities for load bearing structures only. So we will see the methods for taking out quantities. In this, particularly two different methods are there. There is long wall and short wall method, which is again may be called as in-to-in and out-to-out wall method, which will be described in next video. And obviously the second one method is center line method. So these particular things we will cover into the next upcoming video. Thank you very much, and subscribe channel for upcoming videos. Thank you. Thank you very much.